was a complete failure. Terry's got water in his engine and we didn't get across, the current's just too strong. Two choices now, we either wait until the water goes down or we go across the railway bridge.
Yeah. Keeping an eye out and an ear out for trains, and the guy on the bikes has to keep an eye on them and watch the signals.
Just keep an eye out and give us a yell if anything's coming.
Oh, watch the car!
From our vantage point on the railway bridge, we could see that back on the road, a four-wheel drive had failed to cross the torrent and was now stuck in the middle of it. Not long after the crossing, just a few miles before the town of Novi Uayan, Terry's handlebar bolt snapped and he lost the ability to control his bike. Thankfully, his years of experience helped him pull up the bike to a halt without incident, and he then strapped the bars loosely back to the top triple clamp.
Well, my handlebars are starting to fall off again.
We limped carefully into Novi Uayan, where we were met by celebrating former paratroopers. It turns out today was Russian paratroopers' day. The paratroopers led us to a mechanic's yard where the broken bolt stubs could be extracted and the bolts replaced.
I had a set of handlebars and a set of forks, but they weren't joined together.
After Novi Uayan, the road begins to deteriorate. It is well maintained as far as Novi Uayan. The next 200 kilometers to Taximo are in worse condition, but still nothing to worry about. There are increasingly funky sections though, such as this bridge with one collapsed end. The western half of the BAM road offers you a choice of two main riding tracks. The BAM road itself, often right next to the railway embankment, or actually riding on the embankment itself. The Western BAM Railway has an embankment sized for two rail tracks. Most sections only feature one track, and so the second half of the rail embankment serves as a semi-maintained track. Time ticking on and darkness not too far away, Terry and I rode ahead to Taximo to try and secure accommodation for the night. The Norwegians would not have an easy time behind us. A flooded engine would delay them an hour or so.
make you make a dip into someone else's pocket, then make a slip. Steal a car and go to Las Vegas. Ooh, gigolo. I'm on a bus on a psychedelic trip, reading murder books, trying to stay hip. I'm thinking of you, you're out there, so see.
And then darkness. And the bent bridge. It was about 11 p.m. when they made it into Taximo.
What the? Are you tired?
I'm tired.
We woke the following morning planning to do a little maintenance on the bikes, but we ran into a wedding party.
Ah! Congratulations!
Long growth!
Today we're going to cross the Vitim River. Some people say it's one of the world's most dangerous bridges. It's particularly long and particularly narrow and particularly high.
A little bit more.
Steva.
Yeah. Smør litt kjede og styre litt.
And Walter. He's doing the air filter.
Take a chance to clean it while we're waiting for the gear.
Yeah.
I didn't really need to do it, but my
I'm so hungry, I'm eating this wheelbarrow.
Yeah.
I took it out of the bag.
About 30 kilometers east of Taximo, the BAM road turns off a more main road to a nearby town, and it is here that the real adventure trail begins. The trail is no longer a maintained route. The bridges are in a poor state of repair.
Ikke så veldig gamle. Men det klarte jeg ikke. Walter har kjørt her mange ganger før. Du ser han har god teknikk, men han tar ikke noen sjanse, så han
I waited for you and Steve at the junction, at the turnoff.
Yeah, but I have never seen Steve since the
magazine. Saw him at the junction, but he went flying down the main road. And I assumed Steve had turned around, come back and gone on.
It dawned on Eric and I that we had lost Steve. I had putted slowly down the sidetrack, which was the BAM road, expecting Steve to turn around and catch me up. 15 kilometers later, I found Eric, waiting for the two of us. Terry and Geir had ridden ahead to the Vitim Bridge. We realized Steve hadn't turned around and had been riding down the wrong road for the last 10-15 minutes. He did have the GPS track on his maps, so he would pick up the track again in time. Eric would wait where he was for Steve to catch up. I would ride ahead to the Vitim Bridge to tell the others what was going on and not to go any further till Steve was back in the group.
Steve! Hello!
Walter, hold... Si til meg, han sto I krysset!
Og han peker til dit!
Så jeg har fått I oppgave å vente. Jeg har sprøytet meg med myggspray og så...
Meanwhile, up at the mighty Vitim Bridge, the urge to cross it was too much for Geir and Terry, and over they went. Geir took advantage of the extra time to get lots of pics and video from the middle of the bridge.
Yeah.
Terry, who has a fear of heights, was more cautious. And then it was my turn. Soon after I had crossed, Eric and Steve made it to the bridge. Steve showed no fear and was straight into it.
Vitim bridge, jo.
Super. Eric was the last one over. As a skydiving instructor, he probably appreciated the risks more than any of us and decided to walk his bike over.
Har vi tatt med fra Norge, og de har lukket og skranglet bak I sekken I lange tider. Captain Morgan.
I think we should have that before.
No, afterwards. I brought it from Norway.
Very nice. Don't you?
Yeah, of course.
Oh, yes.
Tell you what, Terry, it's a lot nicer today than it was 3 years ago.
Men vi her.
Skål!
Neste magadan.
Oh. Yeah!